This morning in Legal Logic, we are talking about the now infamous story of Ryan Lochte as his legal troubles mount in Brazil after the Rio Games. Here to break it all down for us is attorney Brian Cuna. We were talking.
Good morning.
He really is in trouble. This is no joke.
It's no joke. The Brazilians really took this seriously. You know, with all the problems that Brazil had with the Olympics and so forth, to do something so stupid. Mm-hmm. You know, okay, we get it. He's drunk. Bad night. But right. Then to make up this story the next day about a gun pointed at his head, police officers, very, very stupid.
Right, yeah, Brazil had enough problems and enough bad PR to begin with. It looked beautiful watching it on TV. They want people to come in, but this will only scare people off.
Right. Well, he's now been charged with falsely reporting a crime, which is a big deal. I mean, in terms of the penalty, it's up to a year in jail. But in terms of obstruction of justice, I know in the United States, both Rhode Island and Massachusetts have falsely reporting a crime. Judges in the United States get very, very upset with that kind of thing. And the Brazilians are very, very upset. And they've charged him with this now.
Yeah, you were saying this morning, or you were saying just a little while ago, he's being called back to Brazil.
Right. They want him back there, and they want him to face up to the charges. Whether the United States will ever extradite him, probably not. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have an extraditable treaty with the Brazilians,
right.
But it's only for major crimes, robbery, murder, rape, you know, those kind of things. This is a misdemeanor. They want him back. Will he come back?
Now, does that mean he won't be on Dancing with the Stars?
Well, I'll tell you what. The one thing that Brazil could do, they could send this thing to Interpol.
Oh, Interpol.
Sounds like James Bond.
Look, I've heard about Interpol. I don't know what they do, but it always sounded cool.
Interpol is an international police department,
right,
in France, formed after World War II to arrest basically the Germans after World War II. But if they send the complaint over to France, they could actually issue an arrest warrant for Ryan Lochte in 190 countries.
Wow.
Which basically landlocks him in the United States until he takes care of this mess.
So, I mean, this really is an example of just tell the truth. He had a bad night. He did stupid things. A lot of people do it. Just tell the truth, and this all would have gone away.
Absolutely right. You know the old adage, oh, what a tangled web we weave when at first we practice to deceive?
Right.
That's Ryan Lochte.
So what is his next step? I mean, he's apologized for it. He said it was stupid. He admits to the false report.
Yep.
Does he pay a fine? Do they say, okay, we got it, you were dumb, just we're letting this go?
They want him back, but probably what will happen is his lawyers will work out something with the Brazilian government where he'll pay a big fine and they'll probably let it go. But that's probably what will happen. They won't, the United States won't extradite him. I can't imagine they will.
Right. I mean, this, and it really is, filing a false police report really is, it's a serious trouble.
It's obstruction of justice.
Right.
It's a very serious thing, even though the penalty is a year, but it doesn't matter. Judges in the United States, trust me, they are very, very upset by claiming a crime that's been committed that hasn't been. And the Brazilians are particularly sensitive to this kind of thing.
Good information. Thanks so much, Brian,
for
coming in. Great to see you again. And if you would like more legal advice, you can check out roadshow.com. All you have to do is click on the Legal Logic channel.